In this video, you will learn how to set up a t-square for basic unit conversions using simple conversion factors.
Here's the list of the prefixes to use at the base units that you must memorize. You need to understand the difference between base units and prefixes. Base units include grams, meters, liters, and seconds. These are the units that we use in everyday life. There are times when you need to indicate something that is very, very small or something that is very large. These are the times that you need to use prefixes. If it's small, then you would be using deci, centi, milli, micro, nano, and pico. If it is larger, you would consider using kilo, mega, giga, and tetra.
When you set up conversions with prefixes, you always need to ask yourself three basic questions. If you ask yourself these three questions and understand what you're asking and why you're understanding and why you're asking them, your conversion factors will always be correct. Question number one, which unit is larger? Number two, what do you need more of? Number three, how much of the smaller unit do you need to get to the larger unit? There's also something that you should also think about too. There's this statement in your workbook. Think about which unit is larger and which is smaller. Then you'll need more of the smaller unit to get to the same amount of the larger unit. It is easier to keep the numbers in the positive powers. In model 1, the negative and the positive powers go with the base unit. So how would you use these questions? Well, let's do an example. How many grams are there in 58 centigrams? If you look at your prefix page that you need to memorize, you find grams and centigrams. Note that grams is considered the base unit and the centi is the prefix. Let's ask yourself these three questions from the previous slide. Which unit is larger? Grams is larger than centigrams. What do you need more of? Well, grams is larger. You need more of the smaller unit. So you need centi. Centi is what you need more of. How much more of this do you need? If you do any searches, you will see that centi is 10 to the negative 2 or 0.01. To me, negative powers are a little confusing, so I like to stick to the positive. These negative and positive powers are relative and can be used either as positives or negatives, depending on if you understand which way it goes. So since centi is smaller, you'll need more of centi. Instead of thinking of it as 10 to the negative 2, you will need 10 to the positive 2 or 100 centigrams to get 2 grams. This would be your conversion factor. If you're adamant about using the negative powers, which is totally fine because I understand it, then you could write 10 to the negative 2 or 0.01 grams is equal to 1 centigram. Note that the powers of 10 that you see on the table goes with the base unit.
But like I said before, I prefer not to use negative powers of 10 to solve problems. So I'll stick with the positive powers of 10 to continue on.
So this is what you would have. You would start with 58 centigrams. And since centigrams needs to be canceled out, you would put 100 centigrams on the bottom and 1 gram on the top for the centigrams to cancel out. And you're left with grams. And so the answer would be 0.58 grams. Let's look at this question. A football player has a mass of 1.5 times 10 to the 5 grams. Write this mass using units of kilograms. Let's ask the three questions. Which unit is larger between grams and kilograms? It would be kilograms. Then, what do you need more of? You would need more grams. How much of the grams would you need? Well, according to the chart, it would be 10 to the 3 or 1,000 grams. So your conversion factor would be 1,000 grams is equal to 1 kilogram. So in your problem, you would start out with 1.5 times 10 to the 5 grams. And the conversion factor, it goes in the 1,000 grams goes on the bottom and 1 kilogram goes on top. So the grams cancel and you get 1.5 times 10 to the 2 kilograms. Let's look at this problem. A laser pulse is 150 microseconds long. Write this number in picosecond. If you're learning this for the first time, I suggest you always go to the base unit and ask yourself the three questions and you will never be wrong. You can jump units if you know what you're doing, but I'm not going to show that to you in this video. So let's start with the 150 microseconds. What is the base unit in between microseconds and picoseconds? The base unit is seconds. So let's stick with seconds. So the first conversion is going from microseconds to going to seconds. Let's ask yourself the three questions. Which unit is larger? Seconds. What do you need more of? The microseconds. how much more do you need of the microseconds, which is a small unit? 10 to the positive 6 microseconds. So the conversion is 10 to the positive 6 microseconds is equal to 1 second. Now let's go from seconds to picoseconds. Which unit is larger? Seconds. What do you need more of? The picoseconds. Well, how much more? 10 to the positive 12 picoseconds. And the conversion factor is 10 to the positive 12 picoseconds is equal to 1 second. Let's set this up. You start with 150 microseconds. Your conversion factor, put microseconds on the bottom and seconds on top, and you get 10 to the positive 6 on the bottom and 1 on top. Microseconds cancel out. You're left with seconds. Now let's go from seconds to picoseconds. Seconds goes on the bottom, and then 1 times 10 to the positive 12 picoseconds goes on top. If you don't use your calculator and just use it by powers, you have a positive 12 on top and a 6 on the bottom, then you subtract it. So you would get 150 times 10 to the positive 6 picoseconds. And a few pages before, you learn about moving decimal places and looking at the power. You're making 150 smaller to make it 1.50. So therefore, you need to make the exponent larger. So you move two decimal places from 150 to 1.50. So you would have to move the powers by 2. So the answer would be 1.5 times 10 to the 8th picoseconds. Now convert 8.4 nanometers to kilometers. Pause this video while you're working on it and come back to it when you're done to show the work. So, did you get 8.4 times 10 to the negative 12 kilometers as your answer? And this is the work to show it. So, now I want you to convert 8.4 nanometers squared to kilometers squared. This is the same units as the previous example, but now the units are squared. The thing to know about squaring is that when you square the unit, you must also square the number. So back to this particular problem we have right here. This is 8.4 nanometers to kilometers, but we're just making it one step further, is nanometers squared to kilometers squared. So you have the exact same numbers, the same work, but the thing is, now you have to square all the units. But when you square the units, you must also square the number. And so this meters is also squared, kilometers squared, and this is also squared. So you must square this 1 right here. It's an assumed 1. There's also a 1 right here that's assumed that must be squared also. Just doing the powers of 10, this would be 10 to the 18, and this would be 10 to the 6th. So the answer for this problem would be 8.4 times 10 to the negative 24th kilometers squared. Another conversion factor that you must know and be able to use back and forth is 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeters cubed. You need to be able to use this in many of your problems when you convert it back and forth between milliliters, which is a volume, and centimeters cubed, which is another volume. So the problem that we're going to be working on right now is 1.3 liters to millimeters cubed. So you always start with 1.3 liters. You need to convert this liters to milliliters. So it's 1 liter is equal to 1,000 milliliters. To be able to use a conversion factor of 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeters cubed. Now you got to convert the centimeters cubed to millimeters cubed. So I'm going to go through the base unit, which is meters. So there are 100 centimeters in 1 meter, and 1 meter has 1,000 millimeter. And these aren't cubed yet, so I must enter my cube since I have the centimeters cubed. This centimeter needs to be cubed. This needs to be cubed. This needs to be cubed. Cubed, cubed, cubed. So there gets my units right there. Something to note, this is cubed, not this, not this. Anything past this is cubed because of this unit right here going forward. If I see a cubed right here, a here, or a here, any of these being cubed, I will mark it wrong because that does not belong cubed. The conversion factor is 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeters cubed. So if I keep on solving it, this would be 10 to the 6th, and this would be 10 to the 9th. And the answer is 1.3 times 10 to the 12th over 10 to the 6th, which is equal to 1.3 times 10 to the 6th millimeters cubed. How was I able to do this simply without using a calculator? Some hints for you to use when you're using powers of 10. So you have a 10 to the 9 and a 10 to the 3. You add them together. Those are the powers. So they got 10 to the 12th on top. You have a 10 to the 6th on the bottom right there. When a power on top and the power on the bottom, you subtract them together. And so you get 10 to the 6th.
And that is how you solve unit conversion problems.